everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Shaughnessy, and on this channel we discuss fragrance, beauty, and wellness. And if you simply like to have a good time and you like my vibe, subscribe. So y'all, I am finally getting around to reviewing all of the new releases from Victoria's Secret, you know, in their Fragrance Mist collection. So y'all, I was looking on the website to prepare for this video, because usually Victoria's Secret have the name of the collection. I couldn't find the names of these collections. I think the website is set up differently for the Black Friday and Cyber Monday sales. So I don't know the names of these collections, sadly, except for one, because it's pretty obvious what the name of it is. So I'm sorry about that. You know, in Bath & Body Works, I never have the names. I never know the names, but I do like to tell you in Victoria's Secret, because usually it's easy to find out. They advertise it. But I don't know at this time. So the first collection, I have 12 fragrance mists here. Three different collections. So the first collection I'm going to start with, to me, is like a fruity collection. They're all fruity, I think, for the most part. So the first one I'm going to talk about is Pomme L'Orange. And this has notes of sweet pomegranate, blood orange, and silken fruits. And I do like the packaging of this. I like when they have their tops matching the bottles. I think it's bougie. So this smells like a sweet pomegranate citrus fruit fragrance mist. I mean, it smells like a, gives me the fruity punch scent vibes. Victoria's Secret has done this before. It's nice, but it's nothing that is unique to me. I guess it's unique in the sense, if you don't, there are not a lot of fragrances or fragrance mists with pomegranate. So if you want a nice pomegranate, sweet pomegranate, citrusy, fruit punchy vibe fragrance mist, this is a good one. It's nothing unique, particularly in my collection, but like I said, if you don't have a pomegranate fragrance mist in your collection, or if you want to build, if you love pomegranate and you're trying to, you know, build up the fragrances in your collection, then I do think this is a nice one. And again, this is Pomme L'Orange. I'm probably mispronouncing it wrong. Okay, so the next one is this packaging. I don't know why. I just thought it was adorbs when I was looking at it online. And this is Ruby Rosé. And this has notes of sparkling raspberry and velvet rose dipped in decadence. Okay, so this smells exactly like the notes, okay? It smells like a sweet, musky, raspberry rose fragrance. It's got a little powderiness to it. And again, like I said previously, it smells like a Victoria's Secret fragrance mist. If you have like a substantial collection of Victoria's Secret fragrance mists, or if you've been shopping at Victoria's Secret, you know, for as many years as I have, this smells like a Victoria's Secret fragrance mist. Now, I will say, to me, raspberry and strawberry can be done so badly in fragrance mist. To me, they can smell super cheap, super artificial, and it has to be done right. This raspberry in this fragrance mist does not smell cheap at all. And again, this also gives me punch vibes, party punch vibes. So it's kind of unique in the sense of I'm picking up that rose. But if you've shopped at Victoria's Secret, you might not have smelled exactly this, but you smell something similar to this. So it's good, but not, I didn't smell it and go, wow. I smelled it and thought, it smells good, but it didn't move me. Okay, the next one is Merlot Pear. This has notes of lush blackberry, crisp pear, and glossy goodness. Okay, so when I first sprayed this, y'all, I was like, when I first sprayed this, it was very tart. It was very sour blackberry with some pear thrown in there. And I was like, what in the world? It just turned me off completely. I was thinking this smells like rotten, fruity mouthwash. And I said, whew. Okay. So that was what I thought initially. And then I was like, okay, let me let it dry down. Let me wait. I was doing all that. And then on the dry down, it improves. It sweetens up, but it's still very tart. And it's still a very tart, berry, fresh scent with pear. It gives me nail polish remover vibes, but not... If you smell those scented nail polish removers, I have like another fragrance mist from Bath & Body Works. It's retired sun. No, it's violet. Is it air? Air? What was it? I think it's air. And it makes me think of, no, it's sky. It's the sky fragrance mist from Bath & Body Works. And it makes me think of nail polish remover, but in a good way. I don't know how to make... Some nail polish removers, they have like a scented nail polish remover. They're not as harsh. They're not as chemically smelling as, you know, they used to be. Some of them aren't. So this kind of gives me a tart, fruity, sweet scent. But it's a hint of some, that pear is throwing me off a little bit. That makes me, I don't know, maybe that's what's giving me the nail polish remover vibes. It's not bad once it dries down. It's not great. It's not good. It's all right. You know, it's nothing I can see me gravitating towards. Really. This is probably, this would be a shower spray, room spray, you know, just home spray. But I'm going to try it. Usually I will try things unless I'm just like, no. Because I don't feel like this is one I'm going to want to wear out. But that could change. You know, that could change. Can Victoria's Secret put out, when they bring out their collections, it's usually two or three at a time. Can you bring out something without one of them having pear in it? Everything, at least one, if not sometimes it's one from every collection, has pear. This, the pear doesn't, hold on y'all. To me, the pear throws this off. Because pear can have like a freshness. It can have, some people think laundry freshness. Some people you get a sweet, airy, clean pear. This is one, like right at the beginning, it smells, like rotten pear. That's what I'm getting on the paper. Okay, like a ripe pear. So on this paper, I'm just getting a lot of pear. With some of the blackberry coming through. Some, I've noticed with me reviewing, especially Victoria's Secret fragrance mist, I've noticed a couple of them, they're not blended well. And this is one I feel like right now is not blended well. Sometimes, like I mentioned in, I can't remember what video I was talking about, letting fragrance mist sit and they get better. That might be one. I let it sit and it gets better because now I'm all over the place with this one. Now I'm getting like a tart gummy candy scent. So yeah, this is one I don't feel is blended well. It's not bad. It's okay. But yes, initially though, it was horrific. Horrifically horrible. But on the dry down, like I said, it becomes a tart, sweet, berry, kind of fresh scent from that pear that is kind of trying to come together, but I feel like the blackberry and the pear is separate and they don't mesh. But it's still not bad. It's just, I don't get that one. So the last fragrance mist in this collection is Berry Santal. This has notes of juicy black currant, soft sandalwood, wrapped in riches. All right, this is a super fruity, juicy berry scent. And I don't know why. It gives me grape soda vibes. Again, this is not one that grabs me. It's not one that stands out to me. It kind of gives me like a musky scent also mixed in with that. Like, this is nice, but again, it didn't stand out to me. So I'm gonna rank these four. And number four is going to be Merlot Pear. Number three is going to be Berry Santal. Number two is going to be Palme L'Orange. And number one is going to be Ruby Rosé. So this collection to me is nothing special. It's really nothing unique. I can't see myself. I don't plan to get the lotions for any of these. I can't see myself. I'm looking at the collection. I can't see myself thinking, I'm so excited to wear one of these. I can't. So this collection, this fruit collection, is just, I would give it a C. Average. That's what I would give it. All right, so the next collection to me kind of makes me think it's gonna be maybe their New Year's collection because it has the confetti and I don't know. It makes, because Victoria's Secret usually doesn't come out with anything else until 2023. After semi-annual sale. So we'll see if they come out with something else, but this makes me think this is kind of their New Year's collection. So the first one we're going to talk about is Flower Sorbet. I do like this packaging. It's soft. It's pink. Lilac purple. You see the flower, the little, like I was like little woo! Sorry, y'all. I almost took y'all out. The little confetti sparkles at the bottom. So the notes in Flower Sorbet are black currant, ice, sugared peony, top it off. So on initial spray, I remember when because I can get a hint of it now, I was thinking this smells like a sweet piece of gum, not bubble gum, but you know, like the gum that's scented with, you know, just some fruity gum, but not bubble gum. Cause to me, bubble gum has a distinctive scent. This doesn't smell like bubble gum, but then it turns into a fruity, somewhat syrupy, sugary, wintry, soft, floral, creamy fragrance. Yeah, this is nice. This is nice. Again, it's not something that grabs me, but it is very pretty. It's a very pretty fragrance mist, and that is Flower Sorbet. All right, next, I love the packaging of this one. It's so pink and pretty, and this is Blushing Bubbly. And this has notes of pink champagne, muddled raspberries, and it says, get fizzy. All right, this is a fragrance mist this is leaking. And that's another thing I've noticed with Victoria's Secret fragrance mist. They've been leaking a bit on me lately. But this is a fragrance mist where the name is so befitting, Blushing Bubbly, because it smells like a soft, bubbly pink effervescent raspberry champagne scent. That's exactly what it smells like. Like fizzy, bubbly raspberry champagne. And if there's no raspberry champagne, like I said, this is a holiday season. Think of those, I can't think of the name. Are they Welch's? What, sparkling ice? You know, in the, they look like champagne bottles that you can get, but it's no alcohol. Think of that like with raspberry. That's what this smells like. Again, I hate to keep saying this. Nice, but didn't wow me. Didn't grab me. It's pretty. Again, it's very pink, pretty, and bubbly. Blushing bubbly. All right, next in this collection, I was very, very curious about these last two. And this is Amaretto Fizz. This has notes of almond coffee, orange blossom. Pour it up. All right. This is a soft, smooth, creamy coffee scent. This doesn't smell anything like, what's the one that just came out from Bath & Body Works? So, it's nothing like this. This is not a coffee scent. I was excited to see this coffee scent from Victoria's Secret. I don't remember a coffee scented fragrance mist from Victoria's Secret. Pink may have fragrance mists like that, but I couldn't remember one from Victoria's Secret. So I was interested to see their take on it. So it's nothing like Vanilla Mocha Martini at all. Okay. So this is, to me, unisex. Kind of hint of like a cologne coffee scent, but it also smells nothing like coffee and whiskey. So I was like, oh, it's gonna smell like coffee and whiskey. No, does not. What this smells like, this Amaretto Fizz smells like Replica's coffee break. I mean, when I smelled it, I went, what? It is a complete dupe, in my opinion, of coffee break. And I know some people say Fireside Flurries, and I can see that, but Fireside Flurries to me is sweeter, it's pinker, than it's fluffier than coffee break. Coffee break to me is lavender coffee powder. That is what it is. It's a powdery coffee lavender scent. That is not sweet. It is not fluffy. It is not girly to me how Fireside Flurries can be from Bath & Body Works. To me, Amaretto Fizz is the dupe, the true dupe to Replica's Coffee Break. Yeah. I mean, practically identical. Practically identical. So if you... If you were looking for like a powdery coffee scent, not something that smells in your face of coffee, in your face like a Frappuccino, but just a hint of coffee, comforting, that's what I get. A little creaminess, warmth, that's what this is. And if you like Replica's Coffee Break, you'll like, to me, with my nose, you'll like Amaretto Fizz. Okay, the last fragrance mist in this collection is Sparkling Creme. This has notes of glistening coconut, soft marshmallow, shine bright. Y'all know I saw marshmallow. I was like, ah! So let's see what I think. And yeah, I still feel the same way. To me, I get a minty, coconutty, waxy, marshmallow scent. And then I was like, oh. And I keep smelling this and I think of coconut cream pie from Bath & Body Works. Take away the caramel, take away the crust, and like that toasty coconut that's in there, that's the coconut I smell in this, but with a minty vibe to it. And then sometimes I can keep smelling it and I think of coconut icing for a cake, you know, in the jar at the grocery store. But something is off with this. it's off-putting to me. It's like a note in there that I don't know what it is. It's throwing me off. That I can, it sometimes makes me think of sour milk. I don't know. I was so excited about this one, but it's weird. I don't know. I'm gonna have to play with this one some more, but it's not giving what I wanted it to give. I thought this was going to be a warm, fluffy, marshmallowy coconut scent. And instead, I'm getting like a weird, waxy, marshmallow, minty coconut. Like I said, sometimes I can smell it and I'm getting like that icing note, like a coconut marshmallowy icing for a cake or something, but it's not what I was expecting. So I don't, like I said, this is weird to my nose. Something is off-putting to me. So I might let this one sit for a minute and then come back to it. So let me rank this collection. So of course, number four is gonna be Sparkling Creme. Me and Marshmallow are just not having a good time lately. Number three is going to be Blushing Bubbly, because this also, this is extremely light and faint. I mean, yeah, it wouldn't smell like you were wearing much. I wanted to bring that out and forgot. So that's going to be number three. Number two is going to be Amaretto Fizz, because, you know, I'm impressed that it smells like $120+ perfume, but I've smelled it before. And number one, I thought this is one that's just, it's very pretty. So that's why it's number one, and that's Flower Sorbet. Again, my thoughts on this collection are, it's a C. It's average too. It's not anything in this collection where I would consider with my substantial collection, personal collection I have. And from the many years of shopping and wearing fragrance mists from Victoria's Secret. There's nothing that grabbed me, nothing that was special, nothing that was unique. Nothing, now in this collection, and one, now we're going one from each collection so far, has been a complete and utter, what is happening to my nose? Now, Merlot Pear redeemed itself some, the Sparkling Creme, and then redeemed itself, and that was the marshmallow. So far, I'm not, you know, blown away with any fragrance mist out of the two collections we've talked about. Now, the last collection is the Luxe Collection. This is the collection they do every time they release something. You know, it's their four best-selling core fragrances from their fragrance mist line. So we're going to get into it. This is Love Spell Luxe. This has notes of fancy apricot, blush chantal, an opulent take on Love Spell. Okay, this smells good. It's soft, it's fruity, it's grapey, musky, perfumey. And for some reason, when I smell it, you know how in some of perfumes, you can pick up like a lipstick scent. I'm getting a hint of that in this. I do like it, but again, it's nothing that grabs me, okay? It's nice, but it didn't make me go, whoo, it didn't. I'm sorry. So if you like the original Love Spell, to me, this doesn't really... I can't remember exactly how the original Love Spell smells, because I know it's not one I love. Let me think. I would say it's toned down, it's softer. You can see it's from the Love Spell family, but I wouldn't write this one off even if you dislike the original Love Spell, because it's not one I think about, I love, but I do like this one. It is nice. Okay, next we're going to talk about Pure Seduction Luxe. This has notes of Posh Violet and Strawberry Nectar. Okay, y'all. Well, let me tell you what it smells like. This smells like a perfumey strawberry floral musk. Okay. Now, you hear what I said, but do you know what this smells like? This smells like, has the DNA of that Baccarat 540. It smells like Sol de Janeiro 68 fragrance mist. It smells like Burberry Her line. I don't get cloud, but that DNA, that is what this smells like. So I like it. And again, I'm impressed that it smells like an expensive perfume, but everyone has kind of done their version of the Baccarat DNA, and it's old now. It's old. Okay, next is Velvet Petals Luxe. This has notes of Lavish Star Flower and Patchouli Woods. Y'all, when I saw patchouli, I was like, oh. But I like this. This is a woody, perfumey, floral, light, sweet, but kind of smoky scent, kind of earthy. And I think that's the patchouli coming through. But I will say, these Velvet Petals flankers have not been smelling anything like the original Velvet Petals at all. If you like the original Velvet Petals, you can't go based off, I'm gonna like, if you like the original, you're gonna like this, because they smell nothing alike to me. And vice versa. If you don't like the original Velvet Petals, I would still say you could smell this, because they don't smell, it to me has no relation to the original Velvet Petals other than the name. But it is good. And I will say the Pure Seduction Luxe, it doesn't smell anything like the original Pure Seduction at all. Because it smells like Baccarat. All right, the last fragrance mist I'm going to talk about is Bare Vanilla Luxe. This is the one I was super excited about. This has notes of rich marshmallow and vanilla cashmere. Okay, y'all. Let me tell you what I was expecting. When I saw rich marshmallow, I said, this is going to be bare vanilla with ooey, gooey, fluffy, sweet, airy, marshmallowy goodness. And instead, this smells like, you know, the previous Bare Vanillas. I can't remember the name of it. It's the Bare Vanilla with the flowers on it. It reminds me of that one. It also reminds me of Bare Vanilla Golden. It's a warm, smoky, somewhat a hint of gooey marshmallow vanilla, but not enough. If it's vanilla and you're gonna put vanilla and marshmallow, do it right. Come on now. I need you to make this just a luxe, a luxurious, marshmallowy, divine vanilla scent. And they missed the mark. It's nice, but it's not as good as I was expecting it to be. And it does remind me, it's no Tonka bean in this, but that smokiness I'm getting, it reminds me of that from the Bare Vanilla Golden line that came out in the fall. I think it's Bare Vanilla Decadent or Bare Vanilla. What is that Bare Vanilla with the flowers? Hold on, y'all. We about to test this out. Okay, y'all, it's Bare Vanilla Untamed. And this one is Vanilla Elixir Apple Blossom. So this is the one that reminded me of Sweet Whiskey. It took a minute to pick up that kind of marshmallowy softness. So they are similar, but Luxe is more intense. It is more marshmallow, but it's just not enough. It wasn't enough for me. So Yeah. I'm disappointed in this one because if you're gonna have rich marshmallow and vanilla, I mean, come on now. Why do you have to have the smokiness? It's throwing me off. So it's not bad, but it's not what I was wishing and hoping for. So that's my thoughts on Bare Vanilla Luxe. So let me do these in order. So just me being petty, Bare Vanilla Luxe is number 4 because it's not what I wanted it to be. Number 3 is going to be Number 3 is going to be Love Spell Luxe because even though it smells good, I can barely remember what it smells like and I just talked about it. It's very forgettable. I'm going to say number 2 is Pure Seduction Luxe because it smells good. I mean, it smells like that Baccarat DNA. And number 1 is going to be Velvet Petals Luxe because it does smell different to me, but it still didn't grab or wow me. So y'all, that collection, I'm going to give a C also. So if you couldn't tell from my reviews, do I want to do these all together? Don't I normally do that? Okay. Number 12. It's gonna be Sparkling Creme. Can't get with this one, at least not yet. Number 11, Merlot Pear. Number 10, I'm gonna say is Berry Santal. No, number 10, I'm going to say is Blushing Bubbly because you can't really smell much from it. Number 9, I'm going to say is Berry Santal. Number 8, I'm going to say is Love Spell Luxe. Number 7, I'm going to say is Palm L'Orange. Number 6, I'm going to say it's not going to my top 5. It's going to be Bare Vanilla Luxe because they could have done a lot better on that one. Number 5 is going to be, okay, I'm not going to have the top ones be anything that I feel like I have just smelled before. So I'm going to say number 5 is going to be Amaretto Fizz because it smells like coffee break to me. Number 4 is going to be Pure Seduction Luxe because it smells like the Baccarat DNA to me. Number 3 is going to be Ruby Rosé because it does smell, you know, it's nice. Number 2 is going to be number 2 is going to be Velvet Petals Luxe. Because sometimes that I can tell that patchouli is going to get on my nerves. And number 1 is going to be Flower Sorbet because it's pretty. It just smells pretty. So y'all, these collections, Victoria's Secret has not been doing their thing lately. The last time they were doing their thing is when they came out with the Decadent collection or something, because that was last year. This year, I can't think of any. They're nice, but nothing is blowing my mind. This year, Bath & Body Works is beating Victoria's Secret, at least when they do come out with something new. For the most part, I've liked them all. So these are likable for the most part, but they're not memorable. That's what's getting me with Victoria's Secret. I can't remember them, the ones that are coming out, because they keep smelling similar to other fragrance mists from Victoria's Secret. They don't change up their fragrance mist enough. Bring back collections that were loved, like the Cherry Pop, like the Decadent Collection, like the Sugar Collection, the Sweet Collection, the Candy Collection. Bring back things that people are craving instead of bringing back new collections of a million reversions of what you've done that nobody's asking for. So I will say, go smell these. Don't blind buy these. Go smell them and see if they're different enough, unique enough to you and your collection. Because for me, if I had smelled these in the store, I don't honestly think I would have bought any of them. I really don't. I might have bought Amaretto Fizz because it reminds me of coffee break, and that would be a way for me not to have to go buy that one right now because I finished up my travel spray. I might would have gotten that one. Other than that, I might would have picked up Pure Seduction Luxe because it fascinates me that it smells so much like Baccarat to me, and it's, you know, from Victoria's Secret. But they have Midnight Bloom or Blossom, whatever that's in their other line that smells like it. But to me, this smells more expensive. It just smells, yeah. I like that one. So those would be the two I would probably pick up. And that's no guarantee. Because I might would be like, well, I have something like those, so why am I getting them? So yeah, I would say this was, they're all average C. Average. Nothing special to me and my nose and my collection. And nothing that's very memorable. Like, I remember these two because they smell like perfumes I know of. But other than that, it's not memorable. Yeah, so in store, I wouldn't have purchased any of these hardly. And that's the honest to goodness truth. So my final thoughts, do better, Vicky. Do better, because this is not it for me. I've just not been really impressed with Victoria's Secret starting towards the fall. Was it the spring? I just haven't been very impressed with them this year, if I'm remembering correctly. I have not been, yeah. So those are my thoughts on this collection. Again, I want to stress, they're not bad, but they are not new. They're not unique. They're not memorable for me and my nose. So y'all, if you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please give me a big thumbs up. Leave me a comment down below and tell me your thoughts on these fragrance mist. I would love to know. Like I said, I don't rush and send anything back. I'm going to let them sit. I'm going to retry them because sometimes they get better. A lot of times they get better. So just tell me your thoughts. I'm really curious to know what y'all think about these collections from Victoria's Secret. Please share this video with everyone who just enjoys watching beauty videos because we are trying to get to 10K. 10K subscribers. Okay. So please don't forget to turn on your notification bell so you don't ever miss any of my videos. And as I always say, if you like my vibe, subscribe. Until next time, bye.